We are trying to develop an exploit for a sudo heap overflow. In last video, we did an investigation to look for function pointers on the heap that we could overflow, thus hijack the execution. But currently, our overflowing buffer is placed after all these function pointers and we can only override forward. So now we have to try to find a way to force our buffer to be allocated earlier on the heap or the pointers later. And in this video, we want to develop a tool that can try to help us find such a condition automatically. Let's head in. As I mentioned in the last videos, I don't really have a clue what I'm doing. The idea I have might not work, but it feels like worth trying. So I want to write code that takes a configuration of arguments or randomly generates them, constructs the inputs for sudo, runs sudo, and tells us where the important heap areas are. This way we can check if we found inputs where our overflowing buffer is before a function pointer. But how will we be able to tell where our buffer and the function pointers are on the heap? Let's think about this problem. The first important thought I have is that we should be careful on what kind of sudo build we do this research on. The closer we get to writing an actual exploit, the closer we need to be to the regular compiled sudo binary. For example, for fuzzing and some debug purposes, we used to build the binary with disabled shared. This creates a single sudo binary, which is a significant difference from the real target. The real target is a smaller sudo binary with a shared library that is being loaded. For debugging, we also built a sudo version with address sanitizer that also changes the binary and especially heap allocations a lot. And so because we get closer to exploitation, I think we need to make sure we have a more normal compiled sudo binary to work with only minimal and less intrusive changes. Ideally, no changes. But I hope that one particular change is small enough, and that is to collect heap information. I use a very simple approach. I want to add a few debug printfs to print the heap address of our buffer and the two function pointers. I got the location from last video when we looked at the call stack, so this is where the function pointer was called. Then we can configure and make sudo. Keep in mind, we didn't use disable shared for configure, which means we now have source sudo as a bash script wrapper, and the real binary is in source.libs sudo. A few videos back, we talked about that, caused some major issues. I have PTSD from that. Anyway, to test specifically sudo edit, we of course need a sudo edit sim link to that binary. And then we can try it. Sudo edit minus s 000 backslash, and we get almost no output, huh? No printfs for the function pointers are being executed? This blocked me for like an hour. I couldn't figure out why this happened. We clearly tried to execute those function pointers earlier, so we should reach that code. Why not now? Anybody have a guess what the issue is? Again, this was a dumb problem, and so I decided to keep it in this video just to show you that security research is not ever a smooth, straight path. You constantly have to fight with small issues like this, and these issues are what really cost you time. Well, you see the problem with LDD. LDD shows the dynamically linked libraries and from where they are loaded, and the code where the function pointers are used are part of the sudo shared library. And this is not our newly compiled one, it's a system one, which doesn't contain the printfs. Which means we simply call make install to move our new debug print library into the system path, and then it works. Now we see the heap addresses of a few function pointers. Let's look at this output. The sudo code is executing, and every time a function pointer is executed, the heap address is logged. And this is our buffer address. So if we want to overwrite a function pointer to hijack execution, we have to look at the cases that were executed after we got our buffer which we overflow. Our goal is to find some inputs where one of these function pointer addresses are smaller than our overflowing buffer user args. Next, we need to write a Python script that uses this information to do the heap location research. To better understand what I try to do now, let me quickly summarize how I think about the heap. The heap is full of memory being allocated and freed. These chunks have different sizes, so over time the heap becomes fragmented with holes. When we then allocate new stuff, we look for a fitting hole, and how the heap fragments depends on the size of these allocations before. So if we identify inputs that will control the size of allocated chunks, we can end up with different heap layouts, where our buffer might be placed in front of a function pointer. So what inputs do we control for sudo that might influence allocation sizes? Generally, we don't have many choices. There are only so many possible inputs into a program. Typical ones are standard input, opening and reading files, but also command line arguments themselves or environment variables. And for sudo, basically only the latter two make sense. So we can simply write a script that tries different inputs and logs all input cases where we find our buffer before the function pointers. Sounds simple. But it's not that simple. I'm not a professional programmer, but I'm also not a beginner in programming, but developing such a tool can be quite tricky. And the reality is that you enter now a very time-intensive loop of iterating over your code. You write your code, then you run into bugs, and you always have to verify and test if it does what you hope it does. So I want to save you some time. I'm just going to summarize the 8 hours of building the first working revision of the script. Here's my script after 8 hours. I defined a few different length ranges for different arguments. This already is not a trivial decision. For example, we could use a full random value between a number range, but after a lot of trial and errors and thinking about probabilities, it's very unlikely to get special cases like the length 0 or 1 or max integer. So in the end, I used these biased random values. The number can be anything from 0 to 255, and then we have power of 2s, including a small offset version of the power of 2s. Those should be more interesting length values. Also, I haven't verified if command line arguments for sudo even influence the heap, but to be sure, I just hard-coded some of the existing flags I got from the sudo help. In the main loop, I then generate different configurations of random arguments and random environment variables. Which environment variables, you ask? I decided to use the one typical existing one and one made up. At this point, I didn't know if that actually helps us. This is definitely an area where we could do more research on to identify environment variables that are actually influencing the heap. Anyway, once we have generated random inputs, we can then call run sudoedit. This function is simple. It executes sudoedit with the arguments and environment variables and then tries to read the heap information from the output. Also, see this here? I'm not directly calling sudoedit, but I call stdbuf with -o0 as a wrapper instead. Wonder why? When the code read the output of sudoedit, I oftentimes never saw the heap address information. It was just gone. But testing the same inputs on the terminal by hand worked. It shows it, even when we crash. I quickly had the thought that output buffering could be the issue. Sudoedit might buffer the printf outputs and then comes a malloc crash abort which throws away the buffers. In that case, we might never see the output. So I somehow had to disable the buffering, but there was no way that worked with Python subprocess. But eventually I found a solution wrapping the execution in stdbuf, which can disable buffering of the std output. Now I was ready to find the perfect heap layout and I ran the new script. And yeah, I did start to find a few cases where our buffer is placed before any of those function pointers, and we crash the binary too. But unfortunately, the function pointer buffers are very far away from our buffer, over 10,000 bytes. I still tried to make it work. Maybe you can overflow other buffers with carefully chosen values, so sudo doesn't crash until we reach the critical function pointer calls. I spent hours in GDB and debugged it, basically run the script overflow, look where it crashes, try to manipulate exactly the place in the overflow and change the values to something that doesn't crash and repeat, but it just didn't work. I never could get past 2 crashes. The problem is we overwrite thousands of bytes on the heap. Stuff just keeps crashing way before we reach the function pointer. So I have to change something in my approach. But that has to wait. Let's dig deeper next video.